Follow me.
Speaking in monosyllables don't make you seem interesting. It makes you seem stupid.
I don't care how I seem.
Well, now, where west are we headed, you damn grunting fool?
This ranch I bought just now.
Is that what you were doing in the bank? Spending all your money? Oh, I own a ranch in the armpit of West Elizabeth. Oh, my lord.
Not that that's any of your concern, but I was in the bank borrowing the money.
Well, that's even worse. Yeah, you can run from a bounty, John. You can't run from a bank. Is Abigail there?
No. She's, her and Jack are waiting until I'm set up before joining me out here.
You mean she left you? Oh, I never thought she was a smart woman, but, you know, this makes me think maybe I was wrong.
No more of that. I just bought this place. And you're lucky I'm showing it to you and not looking for a place to bury you out here.
Just wait right there for me.
This is it. Look at her.
Okay.
What do you think?
Why exactly did you buy this dump?
For Abigail?
Why? Is she an idiot?
No.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. She said she wanted it.
She ever seen it? What are we gonna farm here? Rocks?
We?
You don't have a hope here without a wise hand at the tiller.
Enough of that. Get out of here. On your way.
No. You're stuck with me. Seems I'm stuck with you. John, the rock farmer.
So, you think I'm an idiot?
No. I know you're an idiot.
I'm back, girl.
Working hard?
It's the lumbago.
If I overdo it, I'll get a relapse. It's very serious.
Get up or get out.
Oh, you can be so testy. What is it? Constipation?
Guess you're my proof I'll never quite outrun my sins.
You got so sanctimonious in your old age. No wonder she left you. It's like rooming with the King James Bible.
Get up!
Ow! I'm getting up. Oh, no, wait, what did I have to tell you? I went into town and... oh, I got a little drunk. Oh, shit! Well, we gotta go. We gotta go to Saint Denis. Charles Smith is alive, I reckon.
Charles Smith alive? Really?
I reckon. Unless I dreamed it all, and by the sound of it, not doing too good neither. Here we are.
Come on, let's get off.
All right.
Back in Saint Denis. I never liked this place.
Yeah. Well, me neither. All right. Let's go find that big sour bastard.
Sure. Let's split up.
Good idea. I'll take the saloons, you take the slum.
How about I take the saloons, and you take the slums?
Hello. You're new to this part, sir? I'm a blow-in myself.
Morning.
So long.
Whoa. Be careful.
Oops. Oh, dear.
Morning, Dad.
Bonjour. How can I help you today, sir?
Listen, you seen a big Indian fella?
Huh. Indian?
Yeah. A boxer.
No. Sorry, mister. No. Actually, yes. I think he's fighting. Fighting out behind Saint Saturnine.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
No problem. I would head along that way. Saint Saturnine. Enjoy the fight. I think they might be starting soon.
soon.
Them tempered women are back having us again.
Tailored saddle, made to measure. Look no further.
Oh, good Lord. I was just beginning to enjoy some peace and quiet.
Ask that first barman I met, and he told me Charles was here. Not one of life's great mysteries, it turns out.
Folks, they love a surprise, but they hate a massacre. And you are a killer. We both know what you gotta do. I'm leaving now.
He don't know the half of it.
John? You're...
I'm alive. So are you. So's he.
That's Uncle?
What are you doing?
I don't know. I'm alive.
Uncle thought maybe he was in some sort of trouble.
Kind of. Just... I don't know. I'm throwing fights for a few dollars.
Throwing fights?
Sure.
And you like that?
Of course not.
So...
Let me go place a bet. Come on. Man, I thought you were dead.
Sure. Abigail's still alive, too, only she left me.
Excuse me. I'd like to place a bet.
On who?
On myself, to win. Lone Wolf.
How much?
All of this.
Okay. Funny thing, I pegged you for the favorite, but the odds just got real good. What about you, sir? A little wager on the wolf here? Real redskin brave.
Sure, I'm a fan of the wolf. Give me a bet on him.
Have I got a treat for you? An epic battle between the descendant of ancient warriors and a not-so-noble savage. On my left, a ferocious battler from the valleys, Simon of Wales. And on my right, an Injun Hercules. The savage, the untamable, the unbeaten, and dare I say unbeatable, Lone Wolf. You know how this works? No weapons, no forfeiting, no crying like a beaten child. Everything else goes. You win by knockout, you win by retirement, or you win by death. Let's have a good fight, boys. Let's keep it clean, but not so clean.
You know what to do, sir.
Get him, Charles.
What's that?
Almost gonna kill this fool. Pretend he's Micah.
This is not
I've seen you hit whiskey jars harder than that.
Kill that bastard.
Where are you two, sweethearts? Let's have a fight here. Knock him out. Hit him, Lone Wolf. Don't black out just yet. Try and stay on your feet, you hear? Come on, Lone Wolf. Gotta get you the hell out of here.
Hey, Lone Wolf. Whoa. How? Made my month, but you also made some fellas mighty unhappy.
So it goes.
Here's your share, partner.
If we'd just made the bed, I said we
should. So you keen on staying around here or heading off with me and Uncle?
But, John, I haven't seen you two in years.
I know. But right now, my sense is you just need to lie low.
Where?
We got a little place up past Blackwater, in the high country.
Okay. I gotta grab my baggage. I booked a steamer heading upriver. That's why I was pretending to throw the fight.
Okay, boys. I'll meet you at the bridge outside Saint Denis.
What are you doing?
Just have a few errands to run.
You're useless.
I am a deep thinker.
Be quick.
Come on. This way. My bag's on the dockside. So, what happened?
You mean back then? Arthur helped me get out. Gave me a chance to live, I guess. You know that Arthur...
Sure. Word got to me up north, so I went back and buried him in Miss Grimshaw.
I had to run. If any of us had been found, we'd have...
Of course. I understand. He's where he would have wanted to be. A pretty hillside, facing the evening sun.
He gave me his satchel with some of his things in it. Remember that journal he always drew in? I got it.
I'm
a bit of a draftsman myself nowadays.
He was a good man. As much as any of us could be.
Getting sick like that has to rattle a fella.
Rattle him or give him some kind of understanding what his life was really all about.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Anyway, I heard all you were dead. Or I might have come looking.
And me, the same about you.
Dutch?
Who knows? Dead? Maybe? I'm not sure. I heard all kind of things, but one thing I know, he ain't around here. I ain't heard nothing real in years since, well, that time.
Nor me. Micah.
I hope that bastard's dead. You know, he was the one speaking to them agents.
What?
Putting them on us the whole time. Or since before I got off Sisica.
They picked up Strauss. The agents. Made a real mess of him. I heard he died in custody. Never said a word.
Guess some folk is strong in ways you can't see.
Everything that happened. All those deaths. Micah?
None of us is innocent in that. Dutch, least of all. But I don't think we would have had to make those calls. All that mayhem. If it wasn't for...
Okay.
Hold on.
What?
Careful.
Why?
Those are Guido Martelli's men.
Who?
He used to work for Angelo Bronte.
I've only been here an hour.
Hey! Come over here.
What now?
Well, you go left, I go right. On three.
Mm-hmm.
Three!
You couldn't have thrown that fight!
It's never just one fight!
Evidently! Look at those guns they have! So far, the further we get from those gunshots, better chance we have of denying it, at least.
No, we can't get caught. Martelli has the police chief in his pocket. If they take us in, we won't get out of the interview room.
I don't want to get in a shootout over this. That's not the man I try to be anymore.
No, I don't want that either. You see anything?
I think we're clear.
If I ever want to go back, remind me that I hate Saint-Denis.
Guido Martelli. We'll happily remind you of that.
Give me some simple folk and wide open spaces. Speaking of simple...
John! Charles!
You boys been all getting up to no good?
Kind of. Been getting shot at.
Well, they weren't very good shots. Come on, let's head for home.
Feels like old times. It's good to have the old gang back together again.
Let's just hope things don't turn out like last time.
Here he goes. What'd I tell you, Charles? Boy is as sour as week-old milk. No wonder she didn't stay with you. Not even a retired $2 whore would stay with you. That's the goddamn truth. Now, you used to be decent company, but now you're worse than a snake with a toothache. All he does is whine, whine, whine.
Excuse me?
Oh, don't get all angry. It ain't gonna change nothing. You're hopeless. And I mean that literally. You got no hope. I mean, look at you. Look at this place. Your dream home. I've had better nightmares than this dream. Oh, darling Abigail. I've changed. Come live with me in an outhouse I wouldn't ask my worst enemy to take a shit in.
What are you trying to say?
It's awful. It's a dump. The house has got to go. Get some self-respect, you miserable sack of shit. Build a house a lady'd set foot in.
The place just needs a woman's touch.
It needs leveling. No woman would touch this place. Now, I reckon these horses can have it down in a minute. Here. Come on, tie that end around the horses. You loop that end around there. Horses will pull it clean down. We good?
I think so.
All right. Well, let's get going. Now just pull.
You got this, John? I'll go when you do.
Okay. On me.
Come on, pull already.
Give me the signal.
Let's do it. Come on.
The dumb animals don't know what to do. And neither do the horses.
On you, John.
My hands. I need to reset.
Trouble.
And now?
Now we head into town, buy ourselves a house right out of a book. Same as if it were a bicycle.
Where in town?
There's a fella by the train store. Cakes hardwood and timber.
Okay. You keep working here.
But if I don't go with you, who's gonna
just
tell you
that? Need a bit of peace and quiet from your incessant yapping. Charles, make him work. Whip him if you have to. Okay. Jesus. Who'd do a thing like this? Hello? Not here.
This one's still breathing. All the better. Hold him.
Please, please let me go.
Oh, what do you think? Shall we let him go?
I say we kill him. Please.
We got to get that. You don't know who you're messing with.
Thank you.
Sure.
Here's that Skinner brother. What's left of him? Elias Green.
Well, I'll be. Didn't think I'd see this one alive or dead. Throw him back out with the rest of the trash, will you? That man weren't worth spit, but here's what we're paying for him.
It was a nasty business up there. I'll take it.
You come back soon, you'll find another poster on that wall. This fledgling community needs your kind.
All right, girl. Hello, Sadie.
Oh, John. Come sit down.
Sure. You, got any work?
Yeah. Well, there's always work. Whole country's getting robbed, robbing, or stopping robbers. Well, seems like there ain't much else in this world except bastards, victims of bastards, and the bastards who want to put the bastards in the ground.
And which are you, exactly?
Me? In my time, all three. But same as most people.
I guess.
Funny thing about this job, well, opportunity, I just might get to be all three again.
How you mean?
You ever heard of Shane Finley?
Cattle wrestler?
Murder, thief, child killer. He's wanted in 5 states. I caught him last week. He was disguised as a lady in a house for fallen women. I was bringing him in, and I got robbed by a professional rival of mine, James Langton. Oh, he's a nasty bastard. I didn't much like him even before he robbed me.
That happened a lot. This line of work.
Yeah, but they're all people like me. Anyway, now they're holed up in the desert down south waiting to head north so they can hand him in to the state troopers in the north country. I'd given up on the job as just a bad lot, but now that you're here, maybe we can go rob him back.
Is the money good?
Yeah, it's real good. Plus, I don't much like getting robbed by no one. Come on.
Where is it we're heading again, you say?
South. Now come on, mount up. We got a ride ahead of us.
Of course we do. You're a good filly.
Follow me. Let's ride.
Yes, ma'am. That new horse?
Some folk buy ranches, some buy horses. Horses are cheaper.
He looks mean.
He is.
My ranch? It's something else, you know. You gotta come up there.
Ain't had any trouble?
Some squatters, but that's it for the most part.
That's good. Maybe these fellers I heard about have stayed north or gone off somewhere else or dropped down dead in their own tracks.
It's good country.
All country is good. It's just folk that are bad.
You know who I got up there with me?
Uncle.
Besides Uncle.
Abigail?
Abigail ain't come there just yet.
Really? You, want to talk about it?
Well, maybe, but Charles Smith. We found Charles Smith.
Charles? He's alive?
Yeah. He's doing okay. He was prize fighting in Saint-Denis. Weren't seeming too well. He took everything real hard. But I think life on the plains is gonna be good for him.
I always liked Charles. You send him my best.
I will. You know, you could come along too. Build a cabin on the land.
I've done that all before. Can't do it again. I'm on my own now, John. I ain't so good with people.
The offer's there, whenever you want it.
That's kind. Unlikely to be taken up, but kind.
You heard anything of Dutch?
Nothing. You?
No. You'd think. He's a colorful character. Word would get out.
That's one way of putting it. Look, what happened with the gang changed everyone who was a part of it. The Dutch who put a blanket around me after the O'Driscolls, that weren't the same man at Beaver Hollow. And now, he might not be so colorful no more.
You see a man whose character changed. I see a man who got found out for who he truly was. We was fools to follow him. I was a fool and I paid for it. But I was one of the lucky ones.
Micah, John. Micah's the one who set it off.
I blame me for following Dutch for too long, but I blame Micah for most everything else.
He's out there.
And someday, I hope we'll find him. But not now.
Come on.
James Langton, the bounty hunter, has got this outlaw you captured in a women's boarding house?
Shane Finley, correct.
And we aim to have Langton give him back to us before he rides north with him to hand him over to some state troopers?
Correct again. Though the giving back part is optimistic.
I'm forever the optimist. Bounty hunting on my own since I last saw you? I ain't gonna make a habit of it.
We cut off here. This is the place.
It's a view, all right.
Easy.
Go take a look down in the valley.
Come on, John. Help me find them.
I think I see something.
Yup.
There they are. Down there.
Who's who?
Well, the bounty is the feller who's all tied up.
Very funny.
And that big fat feller with the funny hat, that's James Langton. The other fellas just work for him.
Where do you think they're heading?
Come on. Let's go follow them.
Okay, Missy.
Looks like they're cutting through the canyon underneath us. Let's go.
They'll be coming through here.
eye on him. Keep moving, okay? Yeah. You don't want to go over that butte. North through here? What are you doing, huh?
You talking to me or Langton?
Sorry, I ain't used to having anyone with me. My guess is they'll stop up ahead. We can get a better look at them.
You know his thinking pretty well.
If you can't outgun them, you gotta outthink them. The canyon opens up down a ways. We'll head them off there. Up here, get off your horse. This might be our chance. Shane Finley coming off the back of his horse.
What are they waiting for?
The rest of Langton's men, I think.
Langton's doing pretty well for himself. How come he's got all them men and you work alone?
I got you. You're worth 10 of them.
Great.
All right, so what you think? Should we threaten them, start shooting at them, or sneak down and pick them off one by one? I reckon sneaking down is our best opportunity, but it's your call. Make up your mind, John.
Let's just start shooting. Maybe they'll all run off.
Yeah, they'll scatter right away. I'm going over here.
Okay.
Thank you.
kill every last one of you like the...
Shit! That damn heartbeat!
Let's get Finley! Get him out of here! Okay, you're taking Finley.
What's it look like?
Let's go, let's go!
You're a good girl now.
Hey, don't shoot me!
Now let's get out of here. Here, come on! Look out, on the roof bridge!
I need to relieve myself.
There'll be a bucket in your cell.
I'm serious.
Yep, and so am I. Hit him, John, please.
Hey, you don't need to do that just because she told you to. I don't need to be hit. I just want to be treated civil.
Shut it.
You heard the lady.
Thank you.
I still protest my innocence. This woman ripped me out of my bed, kidnapped me, then let Langton kidnap me, then... You killed them all and kidnapped me back. I'm the victim here. Damn you.
John, would you be so kind as to shut him up?
Don't listen to her. Let me speak my piece. There's no call to hit me, mister.
Listen to him squirm. Jesus.
Bad dog.
That's it. Pounding work ain't easy, John.
No, but I can see. Now it has its rewards.
That's a whole lot easier with a partner.
That back there, you didn't need a partner. You needed a whole company behind you.
We did fine. And with Langton and his men gone, there'll be more demand for our service.
Sadie, you know I'm a rancher now. Mostly.
And I know how you're paying for your ranch.
Don't spread that around.
Hey, I won't. But it would be good to have you along some more.
Yeah, we'll see. Maybe.
Here we are. Grab him and bring him in, John.
Sure.
You're a bitch and a bastard.
Brought in Shane Finley.
Oh, great. Let's put him in the cell.
Bastard!
Just put him on the bed. We're gonna watch you swing.
What for? I didn't do anything. Nothing.
Yeah, yeah. I thought you said you lost him.
Well, I did, but we got him back. Oh, and James Langton's dead. We killed him.
Why'd you do a thing like that?
It was him that robbed me.
Okay. Here. There's a decent price on Finley.
Mm-hmm. I know. You want this money to go to the bank, too?
No, I'll take it myself.
Okay, Jim Milton.
It's John Marston here.
All right, well, if you need any more work, you can find me in town. Or maybe I'll find you.
I'm retired.
Sure. Be well, John.
Let's go, girl.
What's your problem?
Who do you think you are?
I see you. Hold on. Small something to do. Well, look who we have here. Done and done. So long.
Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique. But also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. Now, you write your name here. And you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. A fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. If they're Skinner's about, we need them.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinner's gonna be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're gonna be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Niels real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash, though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry. We're not getting shot at.
Oh, yeah. I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? I suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns for hire, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait, look, trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrence. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
maybe I've done this kind of thing before, and maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
I think you might be.
People wonder how you can handle it, living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really.
Hey, we're taking the next right, up towards Manzanita Post.
I was just going to say, when I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it, it really stays there. I don't even think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, he's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. The fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess I figures they'd still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools.
This is the spot. Just up ahead.
Okay.
You boys wait here. After you, Mr. Milton.
Like I said, Niels is an acquired taste.
Niels, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right then, Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, haven't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me, but more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs men like you.
Whoa! Everyone find some cover! God damn! Keep your head down! What the hell is going on? You okay?
Your wag is the least thing.
Captain, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more. They got the tools.
They grabbed Mr. Wayne.
All right, you stay here. Guard the wagon. Charles, come on. Charles, I found the tools. Now, where's Mr. Shit. All right. Jesus. We gotta move fast. Come on. Minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Skitters. Everyone knows.
Except me.
Later, John. Mr. Wayne didn't make it. We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me.
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh, my lord. What'd they do to him?
Nothing nice.
Got it.
Come on, we gotta go.
Those goddamn animals. Okay, John, I'm riding with you.
back to Beecher's. Those were the Skinner brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Sadie said something too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. Skinners move around. They're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with. What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
That was fun for them?
No. Not that time. Most folk don't usually put up with such a fight.
Then I hope we put an end to it.
There was a caravan. A few months back, massacred.
Uncle! Uncle! Uncle!
I was...
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
A lot of them?
Enough. Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devon back to town. I'm gonna pull Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that.
Morning, John.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe.
I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen.
I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. While you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago, unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, well, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
saw in a board and I'll cut it. I'll climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail and I'll nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter what the weather, we're together. Let me have a rule and a saw and a board and I'll cut it. Climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail and I'll nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter any weather, we're together.
And I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. Well, at least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you, and that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John. Uncle, I thought you was... Where the hell? Okay. Good girl. That's a girl. You're good, girl. Just one time I hope to find you working. Just once.
Do you believe in reincarnation, John Marston?
No.
Well, I hope and pray to whatever is out there that I get to come back as a youngin', so that when you're old and facing death, I can be some two-penny slave driver that comes along and hastens your journey into the grave. This is a fatal condition I got.
And I'll give you another fatal condition. We don't get on with things around here, and we'll all starve.
Get on with what?
Farming? Ranching? Planting something?
The only thing that this land's good for is grazing.
Grazing?
Yeah, so cows, sheep, goats. Now, goats is easy, but they taste awful.
I don't like goats. And cows, I've seen enough cows.
Yeah, sheep then. But any livestock, you're gonna need a barn.
Barn will take three of us 6 months to build.
Oh, you don't build a barn, dumbass. What do you think this is, 1785? You buy one pre-cut just like the house. This is the industrial age. The lumber fellers all have them.
That guy makes me hate the modern world.
Oh, come on. I'll deal with him.
I can't move like I used to. And I never was that fast.
You're doing well.
Into Blackwater. Let's go. Now, this fella probably saw you. Thought, here's some corn husk idiot, some country rube, doesn't know a pre-cut home from an outhouse. And I'm gonna rob him blind. I gotta respect him for it. Because if I saw you walk into my lumberyard, just wait right there for me.
Anyway, you carry on.
I gotta respect him for it. Cause if I saw you walk into my lumberyard, I'd think exactly the same thing. Wait for me! We gonna stay together now? You were saying before you bailed on me.
Thinking about it? I might actually do this on my own!
Anymore, okay?
So, what were you saying?
Oh, I can't let you do that, John! I ain't young like you, hold on! Now, as I was saying... Oh, I can't let you do that, John! Let you get robbed again? Oh, no! You need someone with some sense to negotiate! And some charm wouldn't hurt neither.
And that's you, is it? With your famous way with people?
Ah, you're in enough debt as it is. I got to help you all I can.
It's my debt. I'll handle it.
Yeah, but if they foreclose
this
on the debt, I'll lose my home. And I do so like it there.
You like it too much. You're far too comfortable.
Ah, you ain't even got furniture.
are we? How's little Emily?
Emily?
I'm sorry, I've, how are you?
We need a barn.
A barn? Of course you do. All them potatoes.
We're gonna farm livestock.
What's wrong with you? How many scar-faced loons you got coming in here buying pre-cut homes?
Here, what you think? Have a look.
Maybe that one.
That
one. An excellent choice. We have a couple already cut and in stock. I'll have it sent to you in Blackwater.
I'm down at Beecher's Hope.
Oh, I'm sorry. Of course, this is my wife, Jerry. You see, she's, it's great seeing you again, Al.
Yeah,
it's been
a pleasure as always. Great pleasure. Love your work.
Of course.
How are we going to pay for this?
Same way we pay for everything.
I just wish I could help you, sir. You've been a good customer, and I like you, and David Geddes likes you. But this man is very annoying.
Can you just give me a few days?
Of course.
I really enjoy begging and watching you make a fool of yourself.
John! Hey!
Is that Sadie Adler? Hey!
John, how are you?
Well, hello, Uncle. Nice to see you. Oh, and you too.
Oh, shut up, you old creep.
Listen, Sadie, you got any work? I'm kind of desperate.
Work? How desperate?
I need money. A bunch of money. My debt's climbing, and I'm...
You up for a fight?
Is it legal?
Well, it's very legal, but it's also pretty dangerous. With you, it'll be fine, but I wouldn't do it on my own.
I ain't got much choice.
All right, then. Come on.
Look after him, Sadie. He's a delicate flower underneath.
Tell the bank there's money coming in. And get a crew to help with that barn.
On good authority, we can find this bounty at Painted Sky.
I know the place.
Okay, I'll follow you. All right, the Painted Sky tip is pretty fresh, but I don't know how long it'll stay that way. An encyclopedia salesman was up there on the property, couldn't find the rancher, but saw a Mexican-looking feller hanging around. Now, Ramon Cortez is around those parts. He's split up from his gang and stuck in West Elizabeth. It's gotta be him. Holds up, waiting on some out. And we're gonna get to him first. Slow down!
Tidy! Hey, so who is this bounty?
Ramon Cortez. He's with the Del Lobo gang.
Yeah?
You head back down to where we was, New Austin, you're bound to run into them.
Are they Mexicans?
Some, and some Californios, and some regular Americans, too. They're a misfit bunch.
Just like we were. And they're friendly, I bet.
Charming to a fault. Ugh, it's a bad situation out there. Law, except the sheriff of Tumbleweed. He's making a hell of a go of it, but there ain't much there to hold back the chaos. It's real wild, that country.
That ain't much of an advertisement for the place.
It isn't somewhere I'd vacation, but it's something to behold. If you're inclined, you should take a look.
Welcome.
You know, I had some trouble of my own. That gang you was talking about, was they the Skinner brothers?
That's them.
Quality hide makes the hardiest clothes around. Don't doubt it.
Got hold of this feller I'd hired. Ah, he didn't die well.
I'm sorry, John.
We fought back. We was too slow, was all. I wish we'd done better for him.
I'm sure you did the best you could. I've heard, the kinds of things they do to men. Unspeakable things. I hope that's the last you see of them.
Me too. But if not,
I mean to be ready.
That is wise.
You want to hear something? I built my ranch house.
Good for you. Did you make it out of straw bales?
No. It's one of them pre-cut ones. Me and Charles put it up, and Uncle watched and barked the odd order at
it. You seem the ambitious type.
It's solid, though.
If you want a unique garment, you need to bring me a unique belt. It'll be worth it. Never go a hunt without.
You should come see it. It's good country, Sadie. Despite all that.
I try not to fraternize too much with employees. You know, it sends the wrong message.
Oh, that's what I am now. An employee.
Mm-hmm. That's what the bank says.
Well then I guess our fraternizing days are done.
Now, be a good boy and get this bounty for me.
Yes, ma'am.
Every one of my garments is a little different. Because every pelt is a little different. You'll find them nowhere else.
Holler if you get him. Now, Cortez! We've come for you! Come calmly and no...
It'll all be over soon.
You got him?
I think so. He just tried to kill me.
That's about right. Yeah, that's him. Come on. Let's get him to the sheriff. Come on, Ramon. Let's go for a ride. We're going to Rhodes.
Rhodes?
It's different there now.
That hurt. You want money? Gold? My men are meeting me at Dewberry Creek.
Take me there. I'll pay you good. Better than any bounty.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah.
containers around the front for me, will you? I'll get them ready for you.
Come on! I'll give you $100 to kill that bitch! 200! 300!
Mr. Sheriff? Mr. Sheriff, we got Ramon Cortez.
Cortez?
Sure did.
Well done, how?
Found him hiding in a pile of shit.
That's about right. How you doing, Ramon?
Oh, just fine, mister. Hey, how much you want? How much any of you want? I'll give $2,000 in gold to whichever one of you sets me free.
I'm afraid it's a bit late for that, Ramon. You've been a real bad boy. Me and my boys are gonna ride you into Saint Denis and watch them hang you.
Okay. Okay, if you think so, mister.
Oh, I know so, Ramon. Take a seat. Help me guard them till my boys arrive and we can get them out of here.
Sure.
Spent years cleaning up this town. Last thing I need is fools like this thinking they can take us back to the bad old days.
Well, you did a good job.
Sheriff Thomas, you want our friend back. You have about 10 seconds, Sheriff Thomas, before we kill all of you fools. One.
Don't be a dumb bastard.
Two.
This is a good town now.
Three. Let them have it, boys.
Jail apart. He's gone. He's gone.
Well, we brought him in. Now pay us what's owed.
He ain't here now, madam. I don't get paid unless he makes it to Saint Denis.
You want to get shot today as well as rob, mister?
Are you threatening me?
Why would we bother threatening you?
Get him back and I'll get your money. And another $50 besides.
$100.
75. I can't go higher.
Done. Let's go, Jim Milton. Come on.
Okay, Missy. Where are we gonna find him?
He said there were men meeting him at Dewberry Creek. Let's start by looking there.
Sure. You've had some bad luck with bounties being stolen off of you.
And you're about to have some bad luck with getting punched in the face. He got stole off both of us.
Someone must have talked.
One of his boys, maybe.
We were sitting ducks, waiting all that time in that gimcrack jailhouse.
Yeah, yes, we were.
I don't like it.
The sheriff's done a lot to bring Rhodes into line since the time of the Greys and Braithwaites, but clearly he ain't
ain't done enough.
So you think we can trust him?
Yeah. He'll pay up when we come back with Cortez. He's a decent fella.
If we come back with Cortez?
We're coming back with him. Don't you worry about that.
It's an odd thing, isn't it? We'll take $200 from a sheriff who might be crooked himself to go get a bounty. But we won't take $2,000 from an outlaw just to let him go.
If that kind of offer is tempting to you, then go right ahead. But not when you're on one of my jobs.
I never said I was tempted by it. I just said it was an odd thing. How we'd take money from one, but not the other.
Everyone's got to choose what they're loyal to. Themselves, God, the state. If a bounty hunter wants to last, the loyalty's got to be to the one that's issuing the bounties. Plain and simple. I got a reputation for honest work.
So, everyone with a price on their head deserves it, you think?
Sure. Oh, I don't know. Usually, if I got into who deserved what, he guessed every poster, I'd tear out all my hair before I put a rope on anyone. If the price is high enough, you got to trust there's a reason they said it.
I hope that rationale works out for all of us.
Hold up. Down there. Fire. I'd wager that's them. Stay on the road. Let's find a good vantage point. Yeah. By the creek bed. There it is. Keep some distance. We need to take a good look at him before we do anything. They must be camping down there.
Why are they hanging around?
Probably waiting for a boat. There's supposed to be a storm coming through, so maybe that's delayed them.
Perhaps. So what do we do now?
I'm gonna go get them.
You?
Me. You just cover me. I ain't getting you killed out there.
But it's okay for you?
I want to die. And besides, those bastards don't look that tough. They look asleep as far as I can tell. I'm gonna go.
You sure about this? Just don't seem right.
This is my show, John Marston. Do as you're goddamn told. And shoot well. Get shot.
Oh, hold your horses, chica.
Get out of there. I said, get
out of there. Easy, easy, girl.
Oh, you gave up easy a long time ago.
Hey, look out. There's more of them coming.
Hey, estoy aquí.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
Might just be.
Son of a bitch. Well, that's that then. Help me load this fool on the horse.
A lot of crazy bastards. Seems Mexico's a tough place.
Too tough for you, John Marston. I'd stay well clear.
Oh, I mean to, Mrs. Adler.
And we can go. Okay, let's go. Let's get out of here. Come on. time we collected this bounty.
Second time lucky.
What do you think, Cortez? You got any more surprises up your sleeve?
You're a dead woman. You are a dead man. The Lobos will not forgive this. Wherever you hide, we will find you. And we will kill you. You and anyone who is close to you.
Don't get too far ahead. You ain't going the right way.
You're gonna say that now?
I preferred it when you was offering money.
Oh, you want money? Hey, take my money. I got gold, lady.
But you was just saying you was gonna kill me.
Oh, you let me go? I'll forget about all this.
You see, Ramon, what we got here is a trust issue.
Oh, I'm good for it.
You're tied up on a horse, about to be taken to San Denis to hang. You ain't good for anything.
Listen, I swear.
Of course, because all you can do is swear. But you're just saying anything you think might get you out of this. Ramon, I couldn't trust you to pay me. I couldn't trust you not to kill me. Hell, I couldn't even trust you to kill me, if that's what we agreed.
What the hell are you talking about? I got gold, woman. Mister, gold. $5,000.
Well, I hope you left it to someone in your will. Because you ain't gonna find much use for it in the short time you got left.
Ay, damn you, woman. Damn you.
Oh, I've been damned a long time, my friend.
Relax, mister. We ain't got far to go.
Oh, you made a big mistake. Both of you. You should have took the money. You should have taken it. Now we're gonna come for you. I promise you that. We're gonna come for you.
Well, I hope they know just where to find me. Because I'll enjoy the fight. I like the fighting, Ramon. The fighting and the killing.
Paying, you get back to it.
Get him down. Whoa. The sheriff better move him quick this time.
Big mistake. Real big mistake. I'll see you again.
We got him, Sheriff. We got him.
I knew you'd be back, Ramon. You just can't get enough of me. Put him in the wagon for me, would you?
How's the jail?
Needs to get fixed up since this nice man blew a hole in it. Me and the boys will ride him to San Denis right away this time. Come along, Cortez.
Sheriff, before you go.
I'll pay you when I deliver him.
Plus $75.
Exactly. Now goodbye. Let's go, boys.
I'll see you soon, amigos.
Shut up.
Thanks for this, John.
You send my money to the bank for me?
Of course.
I'm supposed to be retired from this.
This? For nothing. Just a simple arrest. Money for old rope.
If you say so.
See you around, partner.
Don't chew your reins off, Missy.
How was your holiday?
I was making money.
And to think, you call me lazy.
You've done a great job.
Well, that crew did help.
Built a house, a barn. Look at this place. I can't believe it. Thank you. Thank you both.
This calls for a drink.
Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. But we go better when we've brought our foretack to Cathead. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, we'll pump it out, and then all hands to sea. When horn and hounds the forest rend, his pack the huntsman cheers. When horn and hounds the forest rend, his pack the huntsman cheers. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, we'll pump it out, and then all hands to sea. What's got at sea we spend on shore on sweethearts and our wives. What's got at sea we spend on shore at sweethearts and our wives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, let's drink it out, and then our hands to sea. Yeah!
John! Get out here! Uncle's gone!
He's fine. Let me sleep.
Get out here now!
That fat man will be fine.
No, he won't. Skinners.
You think?
Of course. My guess is they went that way. But my other guess is they know we're coming after him.
What choice do we have?
None. We just gotta keep our wits about us. We know this is a trap. Let's go.
Yeah.
I tracked him to the road. We'll pick up the trip.
Shit. It's like we forgot about him. We should have been ready.
It happened. There's nothing we can do. Try and get him back.
We let our guards down for one moment.
Hush. Up here. You see that? Blood.
Dear Lord.
They've gone up to tall trees. Come on.
They came this way, so. Wait, wait. Checking the trail. We're good.
John, look. We should agree on something. If it's really bad, this might not be about saving him.
What the hell are you talking about?
If it's really bad, it might. Be better to stop the pain.
You mean to.
I mean, you can live a week without a scalp. But it ain't a good week. A gut wound, you can live a month, but it's horrible. What they've done to him might have killed him already. With only.
Did you hear?
But. Yeah.
You think they saw us coming?
I don't know.
Guess we'll soon find out.
We'll be better off going on foot.
Okay. Leave the horses in the trees there. Stay.
To the trees. Come on.
There, to the right. Two Skinners.
Lookouts?
Probably.
Take one. I'll take the other.
Better be.
Keep your head. We'll find him. Come on. Don't leave me, John.
Hold. Patrol to our left. Shh. Easy. Easy. Hold it.
If they come from the ranch, they'll come this way.
We should have burned it while they slept.
The burning's better if they're awake for it.
He's old and sick. He won't last long.
Then when they come, they'll come for a corpse.
Let them go. He was talking about Uncle. He's alive. Come on. They've passed. Let's go. Hold up. You hear that?
Yeah.
Wagon.
There.
It's dragging someone.
Is it Uncle?
No. Some other poor bastard. Let's follow. It might lead us to the camp. Keep on him. I think I see something. Yeah, that must be their camp.
What do we do?
Let's get up on that boulder, take a look.
Hang in there, old man.
Okay, okay. I can't see much through this mist. Can you look too?
Hold on.
To the trees. Come on.
there, to the right.
Two Skinners.
Lookouts?
Probably. Take one, I'll take the other. They're waiting for us. Uncle should be close.
He better be.
Keep your head. We'll find him. Come on. Hold. Patrol to our left. Hold it. Easy. Easy. Let them go.
If they come from the ranch, they'll come this way.
We should have burned it while they slept.
The burning's better if they're awake for it.
He's old and sick. He won't last long.
Then when they come, they'll come for a corpse.
He was talking about Uncle. He's alive.
Come on. They've passed. Let's go. Hold up. You hear that?
Yeah.
Wagon, there. It's dragging someone.
Is it Uncle?
No. Some other poor bastard. Let's follow. It might lead us to the camp.
No!
Stay with it.
He was gonna take us to them.
Damn it. We have to find him ourselves.
On me.
I think I see something.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that must be their camp.
What did we do?
Let's get up on that boulder, take a look.
Hang in there, old man.
Okay, okay. I can't see much through this mist. Can you look too?
Hold on. God, we gotta go get him.
Careful. Where are they? Where are they?
I don't care.
Come on. Charles!
Behind you!
They came for
okay, old man?
I look okay.
You look awful. You'll be okay. Those bastards. We got them. Looks like we got here just in time. God damn it.
I'll carry him. Come on, Uncle. Come on. Ready?
Got him? Because here come the rest of them. Quick! There's more of them. I'll cover you. Come on. Here come the rest of them. Quick! There's more of them. I'll cover you! Come on!
Down that gully! Get me out of here! On top of us!
It looks worse than it is.
Burns don't always heal easy.
Sure, but I think this will be fine, as long as it don't get infected. Much better than I feared.
Hear that, old man? This could have been worse.
He's pretty weak.
Yeah, I bet. Stay with us, you old bastard.
I don't feel good.
Over here.
Almost back.
Hang in there, old timer.
I can't hit my back.
He needs something for the back. Come on.
Feeling real weird.
Uncle. Hey. We're here. All right. Let's get you down. Be easy. I got you.
Come on. Let's get him out.
Thank you, boys.
Don't mention it.
I thought I was dead.
Don't get all sentimental now, old man. Then I'll really think you're dying. It's gonna be okay. A few days, you're gonna be just fine. You're a survivor.
Easy. Okay. He'll be fine.
You think they'll be back?
Maybe, but I doubt it. We must have killed most of them. Now, this is your land.
Was it theirs once?
I don't think so. I met a fellow said the Skinners rode down about 2 years ago. They're just angry men on a rampage, and we got in their way.
Sort of like we used to be?
Yeah, exactly like we used to be.
Maybe we should take up torture.
We got Uncle singing instead of torture. We're gonna be safe here, John. Hmm? You, your family, you all be safe.
I hope so. I really do. If she ever comes back.
You always did have that fine way with words.
You doing all right, son?
Sure, Pop. Can I go see the house?
Sure.
Just give him some time. He'll warm up. It's quite a place you got here.
It's yours.
Ours. I should see about that boy.
Who's my new rival?
Oh, that's Rufus. He's loyal, dumb, and angry, so we're reminded to see you.
That's your idea of a joke, miss?
I guess.
Come on!